The colors for this painting are
Yugamboj, Kinakadron Gold, Kinakadron Burnt Orange, Azo Orange for the warm colors, Purple, Cobalt Blue, Ultramarine Blue for the cool colors. I have this sketch of the still life drawn on Arches watercolor paper. This is 140 pound cold press paper. So I'm going to start with the initial wash, the first layer, maintaining all the whites. And I have a detailed drawing of the light areas that have been marked. So starting with the lighter value, that's the new gamboge. Laying the color wherever the darks are and softening the color. And the paints are fairly wet, so it remains wet, so it's easier to blend and drop in other colors into it. And using a wet brush and softening the edges to have the lighter values. Picking up some of this color onto the stainless steel jar here. Light is reflecting from this object onto this object, so you want to get some of the colors onto the adjacent objects too. Going with the lighter wash, new gamboge. And want to have some of the color popping on this object here, so just a light wash of new gamboge into the darker areas, getting a little bit onto the plate, color being reflected onto the ceramic object. And softening these colors out into the background while it's still wet. So I chose a big round brush with a good point, keeping it wet by dropping more water. Since we have the color going on here, just get it on to the foreground, and onto the stainless steel object, getting some of this color heating onto this mug, softening the color since it's very light. Moving the colors around. Adding more of the color to keep it wet. Painting around the white areas. And coming back to this one. Have light showing on this part. Just leave it white and pull the color onto the rest. So we have a little bit light here and a little bit light showing on here, and I just paint the rest, pulling it onto the foreground. Now moving on to Kinakadron Gold. Wherever I see the middle values, I just drop in some of those colors. And if it bleeds onto the background, that's fine. A little bit of azo orange mixed into it to have this orange effect. Paper is still wet. I'm getting some of those colors onto this stainless steel. You have colors moving around the picture. So dropping some of this new gamboge. And picking up cobalt blue onto the shadow areas, having some cool colors. Working your colors around the painting. Getting some of the brown onto the shadow on the plate. It's the quinacridone burnt orange. I stop, leave it to dry completely, come back with the next layer. Choosing quinacridone burnt orange. And checking for the values, adding the middle tones, magenta, and softening the edge with the new gamboge, keeping it lighter as it goes towards the light. So while the paint is still wet here, I drop in cobalt blue, little ultramarine blue, the darker values. Thank you. adding some more of the reflection of this brass onto the stainless steel cup. Little bit magenta. The good darks. And taking off some of the light. Light is coming in this direction. So just picking up some light. Now getting the shadows under the coffee bean. You can go around burnt orange with a little bit ultramarine blue. Now getting the calligraphy on the mug, using some pyrrole red, having a thin Chinese brush, getting the final details of the shadows under the coffee bean. The painting is done. Hope you enjoyed this still life lesson. See you next time. Thanks for watching.